Hi. How do you know you have achieved your goal? I'm pretty sure that we all have goals. It might be what you want to do or what you want to become, and that might be a goal you have dedicated yourself to achieve. But how do you know you have achieved it? I'm Jobin John, and I'm gonna let you know when you have achieved your goal. Now, as you can see, there are a wide range of possibilities that you can try to conquer or try to be good at. As you can see here, there are different types of jobs, different types of sports that you can get into. But whatever it may be, there might be a few times that you have thought to yourself, am I capable of this? Am I good at this? If you think you're good at what your goal is, that on its own does not make you good at it. That on its own does not help. But then when do you get good at it? And then that's what I'm going to talk about. So listen, the number one indication is when someone approves of it. For example, you want to have a good handwriting, and sometimes you assume, yeah, I do have a good handwriting, but judging by yourself. But as I told you earlier, that's not it. Well, when someone else comes to you, takes your book and reads the text that you write, and he says, this is good handwriting, this is a good handwriting, and if he likes it, that means you've already done the first indication. When someone else approves of what you have done, that means you have achieved about one part of your goal. You have been good at it. Like, I remember I used to think I was good at football. I'm a football fan, so I play football with my friends. And I don't really know if I'm good at the game, if I'm good at ball control. But my friends came and they told to me, dude, you're good at the forward, you can be a striker, you can score goals, you can do it. And then that's when I knew I was capable and I have achieved what I wanted to be. Now, the second indication is when you are no longer compared. Now, yes, I know you all have experiences of being compared to your friends by your parents. Like, even I've been in that situation, I know how it feels. But sometimes even you might compare yourself to the others to find out what makes him different from you, him or her. But when you no longer have to compare yourself to the others, which means you can't find anyone to compare yourself, that's the second indication. That's when you know you are good at what you do. It shows that you are incomparable. But yeah. So with that said, always make sure of these things before being confident in your capabilities. I mean, yes, you need self-esteem in what you do. You need self-esteem. You need some confidence when you do something. But don't be too kind to yourself. That's what I'm trying to, I'm trying to portray here. But yeah, make sure of these two points, and then if these two are done, I can guarantee you that your goals, what you wanted to be, or what you wanted to do is done. Thank you.